Very nice meeting you. Thank you. Hey, cool.
Right. Nice.
Yes.
That's the word.
Yeah. Perfect timing.
My turn. Okay. Hi.
Hello, Mr. Thorne. Yeah. How are you?
Yeah. Hi. Allison, how are you? Nice to see you. Good. And then you're
how are you doing?
Pardon me?
How are you doing?
Hanging in there. Yeah. You know. Thank you for taking the time to see me today.
Thank you for coming in.
My pleasure.
So, I'm sure you're familiar with the process as this is a reappointment for you, but just for the audience, the viewing audience, we will take turns asking questions. And then at the end, if you have any questions for us, feel free to ask. Actually, I'm going to let Councilor Campos start this time.
I'm sorry, I know Councilor Butler very well.
Yeah, Councilor Vanessa Campos, District 1.
All right.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you as well.
Yeah, so I was impressed with your background here, your application. You're very active in the volunteer, and I can see, I like the shirt you have on with the black top.
Yes, I apologize that I didn't wear my stadium commission, but I was just interviewed. We had to clarify the tragedy that took place. Mm-hmm. Some of the social media had reported that the shooting had taken place at Blacktop on the course.
Mm-hmm.
And it got out that way, and some of the people who are involved in Blacktop as far as bringing their kids and bringing their teams in have called Veronica since that has happened, and they would like to not come in anymore. So it was, she's very upset.
Because yeah.
All they do, everything is given from their heart. They don't make any money. There's none. There's no money given. So all the work that she and her family do and the rest of the board, you know, we didn't want it to go up in flames because of a false report. There was no shooting. There was no problem on the court. There has never been. We're there 30 years. There are a few antics sometimes in the conversation, but those are people from the playground, from the outside. They're not.
Thank you for clarifying for your advocacy.
I hope you didn't mind me saying that.
No, no worries. So aside from your impressive background here, also a former city council man as well, my question is, how has the city assisted the commission, the stadium commission, and is there more assistance necessary from us?
From us as in city council?
Yeah.
You're referencing. Well, you do have a liaison on board, and you do have a member of council, Pandana Reed, who is there. So, you know, it's not as if actually the city council is ever in the dark, because for the most part, whether it be Donna or whether it be another appointed council member, they bring a lot of information to us and we then to them. As well, you know, for example, if there are, if there are seems to be a problem with light or the electricity, or there's not enough, or the situation in the bathrooms, that those are kind of things that we sometimes hear if we circulating stands. You know, you might hear something like that. I don't want to say never, but it's very, very rare that we hear negativity. You know, whether the prices of concessions or the way the vendors treat you. I mean, everything is very, very positive. If there was something afoul, we would say it. Maybe city council might want to up the $5,000 a year, because $5,000 has been the amount of money that council figures for improvement. Well, you know as well as I, but $5,000 to buy a whole lot of money, and that's been the situation for quite a while. But knowing that city council and the county clerks and everybody has been chipping in so incredibly to get this thing built the way it has been built, so it would comply with Major League Baseball, we decided, okay.
Yes.
we decided that we would put that on the back burner.
Okay.
But no, and I promise you that if you feel that we have great work to do. And if you feel that any of us or myself would not be worthy of going, or especially if you do feel that we're worthy of going, and it's something we can say something for you, we would make a suggestion that it be done.
Thank you for your response. That's the only question I had. I'll pass it on to
Councilor. Thank you for your time and for your service.
Thank you for taking district board responsibility.
My question is, how is the commission's relationship with the organization? So how's the commission's relationship with the Phillies organization?
I think that has been chairman. He is just a wonderful man. He's very personable, and he's so easy to talk to, you know, so that when he talks to Scott or anyone else in management out there, it's always, you know, it's very polite, it's very cordial, and the response is the same. So he has, we want to have a very, very good program with the front office and their staff. Very, very good. You know, so I think that's a positive. I really don't see anything that would be a negative that way.
That could still be done in the future, maybe not now, but something that you feel is missing or lacking?
Well, in fairness to the old they used to have parking and they had fireworks and you couldn't go on there when you had fireworks. Well, the plans for that are not finalized. You know, the landscaping and the hardscaping isn't finished yet. So I think that probably we have not had a meeting in a little over a month. So I would think that I haven't spoken to any of the contractors, but I would imagine that this weather has really, really hampered the hardscaping, you know, all the landscaping, the planning, things like that, because it's very little rain and it's just so terribly hot, as you know.
We all do.
You know, so it's kind of a negative all the way around. I mean, if you have
Did you have any questions for us?
Oh, no. I certainly appreciate having gone through this myself. I happen to appreciate very much your time as a counselor and what you try to do. You try to make decisions that are going to benefit all of them. And that's not an easy thing to do. Very well. Can't please everybody. And, you know, you have to take that decision. I'm sure you're fine. So I just appreciate that you allow me to come in here and talk to you, and I appreciate what you do.
Thank you for those kind words.
Including my buddy and Linda.
Yes.
I could not leave without saying, give a plug to Linda, right?
Yes, thank you.
You're still playing, Boop?
I do it for fun, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I never stop.
Are you finished? Is everything finished at all already, you know?
No, still, I got about a year left.
Oh, yeah. So,
I'm off.
Congratulations.
Okay. Shelley will explain what the process is from this point on.
Okay.
So once you are out of the room, the committee will talk about your interview and they'll determine whether you are reappointed or not.
Okay.
You'll hear from me tomorrow. I'll give you a call and confirm one way or the other just to let you know how things worked out.
Okay.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Thank you for taking the time to come in. To
my pleasure. Absolutely. My pleasure. Don't hold it against me. I have this cane right now. I mean, it's a little slow with my legs, but I'll be okay.
Nice.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Nice meeting you.
Yes, thank you.
Don't forget your glasses.
What did I forget?
Your glasses.
Thank you so much.
You'll remember when you're outside.
Honestly. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Have a good evening.
Take care. Stay cool.
Thank you. You as well.
Thank you.
Wesley, my best to your parents.
Yeah. Send to your family.
You have great hair.
Yeah, just put stuff on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He goes to my barber.
Does he?
I wish
really,
I
really, yeah, really great hair.
Beautiful. I noticed the same thing. I'm so weird. I'm looking at
it. Well, I'm a hairdresser, so I don't call myself weird.
Okay, let's have a discussion on Mr. D'Annunzio first. obviously very dedicated, which came through as he spoke, and very committed to the point where he said, I've only ever missed one meeting, and that was because of a family illness, which is understandable. And very honest, the fact that he mentioned that he stepped away because he had a conflict, which I thought was, you can't get more honest than that. And I think all three of those are good qualities for somebody to be reappointed.
I agree as well. And his transparency, commitment, he mentioned, he was very proud of that, not missing anything, and wanting more members to be part of, even though downsized, but he sees the importance and the value of that participation.
Yeah, I agree. And this is one of the board that you don't hear about negatively, I would say. So when I think about that, I always think it's best to keep those people on the board, especially when they're still dedicated no matter how many years they've been there. So,
yeah. So I'm in agreement.
Yes.
Yeah.
All three.
Cool.
And then for Mr. Short, who I think it's interesting, the fact that he was also a city councilman brings like another viewpoint to the commission that probably some of the other members wouldn't have. So the fact that he served on council, he could probably see things that they don't, which is an important thing. He also shows dedication to the commission and to the ballpark. He's obviously very proud of everything that's happened. And again, you know, very realistic, the fact when he discussed about the ask of council, but he mentioned that the money that came through the ARPA funds, that it sort of became a non-issue for now. But right. It was a good conversation. So there's definitely a lot of knowledge there that's important to keep with the commission.
I agree as well. Yeah, his experience as a former elected official and then all the volunteer that he has done and is still part of, I think in his answers, you can tell he's such a gentleman, very dedicated and giving. So he would continue to add value to the commission. I agree with his reappointment.
Yeah, I agree, another dedicated member. Definitely like one of the more famous people in my district for being nominated. Not just one organization or commission. Like he said, he's a blacktop. And you know, he's been doing this for some time now. So yeah, I agree.
And as a sidebar, not that it's related directly to Mr. Shorn, but if you recall a couple months ago, we actually interviewed his wife too. One of the, which board was that?
Health.
The health board, which is pretty incredible to have a husband and wife.
Very active.
Especially when a lot of people are thinking about like sitting back in their easy right. chair and they're just both gung-ho to serve their city. I mean, you have to give credit there. That's not like,
they're definitely in public service.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I am all for Mr. Shorn staying on the stadium commission. Okay. Well, that was easy. We like nights like this.
Yeah.
All right. Review of pending applications.
So once Mike and Ricky come off of that memo, I have one that is in the, and is currently in the background process. I'm not sure when she'll move forward. It'll depend on how the timing is for that.
Okay. And am I allowed to say this? The memo that came out today about the Environmental Council, did you see that?
Yes. The subcommittee?
And so will we need to enter?
No. So that is not a voting EAC member.
Okay.
the subcommittees and then grabs non-EAC members to help get their work done.
Okay.
So there's only pull in others, and that's where person would okay. be filling that.
All right. And then what else? All right. Motion to adjourn.
I wanted to ask about so I'm following and I'm understanding. The open positions in the box are those that people are either not interested in getting reappointment or just vacant. They just, said step down. So those are the ones that people can see are open.
Yes.
But if someone is their term is coming up and they say they are interested in the reappointment and they come to our interview, that's not really open. That's not like an open position.
Right.
Or is it?
I struggle with that. And I call it open only because I don't want the public to be confused that we're interviewing people for a board that's full, if that makes sense. So even if it's the same person who's vacant, their term expired, they're coming for us to be reappointed. Technically, it's vacant, but not really vacant.
Yeah.
So it's kind of hard to describe that. And I don't want to.
Their positions are listed as.
So on this grid, you'll see that it says two openings, two applications pending.
Okay.
I don't know how else to describe that without it being too confusing for the public who looks at it, thinking that we're interviewing for positions that don't exist. Like it's already full. Why are you doing two interviews tonight?
So the reason I'm asking is if someone's due for a reappointment, right? They're interested.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't, and I don't know how this works, and I'm probably not getting it right. Like we can't have other candidates interested in that position, or can we? Like, for example, the NOMS committee can interview for these two reappointments. We can also interview others that if they're watching closely for vacancies, they have an equal opportunity, and then
yes.
we decide whether we go with a new applicant or the reappointment. Is that something that, and I don't know if we already did that already, I'm just losing track, but is that an opportunity available for all? Because I know some
yes.
public comments complain about that, and it's like, well, it's my understanding that it's open for everybody. So if you're not tracking or you're not looking for an availability, we can't kind of show it. We can't tell you're interested in something. It's out there for you to track, apply, you come forth before us, and then we make a decision based on.
Right, and that scenario necessarily hasn't happened, but what we have okay. encountered is if there's one vacancy and four applicants. So you interview all four and then choose which one. So there has been that situation before, but I don't recall there ever being a reappointment scenario like you just said, although it could happen.
Mm-hmm. So that's why I was asking, does the public know, like Chris mentioned, this is two vacancies, even though those that are already in the seat are interested in a reappointment, but it's not guaranteed until they don't go to the interview with us. So
right.
shouldn't that be open for everyone? And you said
right.
it is, it's
mm-hmm.
coming up, okay. Because if it's not, then it looks like two interviews where there's no openings.
Right, so. Which is why I feel like if I list that there's no vacancies and we're doing two interviews, that doesn't make sense to the
right.
general public.
But I think the whole point of the reappointment is because there's a term and we're opening up for everybody to have equal access. No one's interested, we'll go with the ones that did show. So, okay, I'm understanding it correctly because some people see that we keep doing reappointments.
Right.
But if you're not applying, we don't have choices to compare. So
correct.
That as well as in translation, like we just want the same people. But if the same people are showing their job and the only one's interested, we don't have choice. So
right.
And there could be a time that one of the reappointment applicants, you may not have liked the job they were doing.
And they don't want to.
They want to get reappointed, but we have somebody disagree. Now we still have, we may still
then you create that vacancy. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so.
So how, I know the boards, commissions, and authorities spreadsheet,
mm-hmm.
and I can see the members listed and where, when their term is expired. Is that something that you provide in our agendas too? That?
Yeah, that's this big, long thing at the back.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So they can see that.
Yeah, that's part of the public agenda.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So they're, if they're looking through,
if they're looking through, yeah.
See, okay, there's a, this guy's up for reappointment. Mm-hmm. I can put my application in for that. I want to be on that.
Running against an incumbent for election.
Right.
Right.
Correct.
Right.
Correct. So it would be the same.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, it makes sense to me, but we get a lot of like comments about, I mean, it doesn't, I don't know, what's the what are we misinterpreting with? Okay.
Yeah.
It's off of our hands.
You know, we do get comments about the criteria to be able to like make a board. And I was wondering, like, when's the last time we ever even looked at the criteria and said, oh, we should keep this in, or
let's switch it up.
But I don't know the last time, I don't know, Michelle, if you know the last time we looked at
it. We've kept it the same since we've instituted that, and that was back in the early 2000s. But it's basic. It's are you a resident? Do you have any outstanding parking, like an exorbitant amount? If you had one yesterday and it's not due yet, that doesn't count. If you have $700 worth of 3-year-old parking tickets, then that's a problem. It's property taxes. And it is sewer water bills, trash, and it is open criminal or civil cases.
In other words, you have to show you're a responsible citizen.
Yes.
So when you say revisit that, what are you saying? Like you're thinking that what's now we should tweak, change, add, eliminate? Like what are your thoughts on those?
Well, there's not, from my opinion right now, like there's not something I can think of that's like, oh, this should be changed. But I've heard it at our meetings that, oh, like from our constituents, some of their opinions is you're not getting these positions filled because your criteria
is too strong,
to meet. So
but
that's why I just brought it up, because I don't feel like we ever brought it up. And it made me wonder, when's the last time we ever
Yeah, so it's typical. I mean, I don't do you don't have an FBI clearances or child safety unless you're on specific boards. It's not anything horribly intrusive, and it's all public information. So
I think you said at one point when I asked, I think it's not held against them. Like you have to answer that, but we're not.
So if they're making an attempt to pay off the debt, say they have $3,000 in arrears for taxes, but they have shown that they're making an attempt to pay off the debt, we don't hold it against them. We'll still move it forward.
Right. So they'll, if something shows up when I'm checking for them, they'll get a formal letter from Linda telling them exactly why, you know, this happened, and we provide the telephone numbers and how to verify. You know, sometimes things happen and it's John Smith, and it could be the wrong John Smith, or, you know, those kinds of things. So we've had that situation in the past as well, but anything that comes up, we hold their applications 90 days to contact whatever office the issue is. Get verification that that has happened, they'll come in for an interview.
Okay, so they have an opportunity to amend that situation, and then when they come before us, is either amended or they took care of it or they have none.
Right.
Okay.
It's very similar to the Blighted Property Review Committee with the ASP water bill, the same thing.
Yep.
So it's not just
right.
And if I have a very serious question, those are the ones that I will ask Mike Gumbar about.
Mm-hmm.
What did you say, like, the criminal record criteria is?
It's any open case. So if something in your past would show up, because it doesn't ever go away, as long as it's closed and you've not had anything since then, I will check with Mike Gumbar about those kinds of situations, and then he determines, yes, they can or no, they cannot. Because recently, someone was disqualified from with their application.
No felons, right? Like,
correct.
That's automatic. But like, somebody has a bunch of messages.
Yeah, that's, or if it's a criminal case because you got evicted when you were 17 and you didn't understand how to pay your bills, that's not gonna be held against you for your entire life. That's, you know.
Okay.
I don't think it's that strict. I just think, you know, if you're a law-abiding citizen, you're doing all those things already. You know what I mean? Yeah. Make a mistake.
Right, and everybody overlooks bills now and then, but it's not something that's going to hold me back for forever.
And I don't think that we're in the business of dissuading, you know, people from being volunteers. We want volunteers. So it's not like we're like making up these exorbitant rules.
What's the total number of people that participate on boards and commissions, approximately?
It's 325, mm-hmm. give or take. It's a lot to manage.
The other question is just following up on the organizations for the youth. We mentioned that last time. Did you mention where we
I have
it?
Not
you
had a chance to reach out to them.
Send us another email. She got it. She's going to check in where we're at. And
That's
because of what happened over the weekend and everything. Well, now, we kind of got hammered at that event because of, you know, the youth and the violence and all of this. I'm like, just want to check in to reach or have a list.
Is very familiar with the commission. She knows it exists. There were, in the past, the commission members were going to her meetings. So there was a relationship there. I think the person who was participating is now off the commission, but she's aware they exist. I'll reach out to her again. She's top of my list.
Overall, aside from Edna, other organizations that are working with you so that we are, at least I'm aware and I know what they're called, what they do, I can meet with them and get a little bit more involved. But I know Edna's very good at sending her minutes and her agenda. She's one that will stay, you know, on top, but everybody else I don't hear about, I don't know. And of course we get called out for not doing enough. And it's like, well, sometimes it takes a little bit of homework to figure out what's out there.
Yeah, I did think of a few. That's in my pile. At some point, I'll get down to that in my pile and it'll remind me.
I remember because I was at the visual and that was a conversation. It's a hard conversation.
Yeah.
So why not? We can adjourn.
Wes?
You got it. You can adjourn.
Hey, meeting adjourned.
Helps us up a little bit, but I always learn something.
It was good.
Yeah, thank you.
Recording stopped.
Where do you get your water cuts?
Mm-hmm.